when there's an emergency, it brings out the very best in people. And in an emergent situation, usually the best outcomes are born from collaborative efforts.
CERN is the Collaborative Ependymoma Research Network. For those of you not familiar with ependymoma, I'd like to welcome actually all of the people here today, our researchers, our physicians, but most importantly, our patients and their families who are here. Ependymoma is the third commonest brain tumor in children, and it's the commonest spinal tumor in adults. And that disease, which unites both children and adults, has led to a really unique collaboration here between St. Jude and MD Anderson Cancer Center, which has been fantastic. And really, for the last few years, we've been working together with a number of organizations around the nation to try and tackle this problem of ependymoma.
And I'm happy to report to everyone that due to this collaboration and patience and hard work, Colin not only has survived, he has thrived. He's a child who's been able to celebrate birthdays, attend school, be a child. It's because of this hard work and dedication that you all have put forth that is going to allow Colin future happy moments. So from the bottom of my heart and from my family's heart, I want to thank you.
Kimberly's son Ryan was diagnosed with ependymoma in 2007. The 9-year-old fought a valiant life against this disease, enduring 7 surgeries, 2 rounds of radiation, and 4 different kinds of chemotherapy.
On May 26 at 3:40, Ryan lost his battle to cancer, but he won the prize of being called home to be an angel. Thank you, researchers and doctors, for all that you do.
So what I would like is for everybody who has an envelope, you have a, don't release it now. I'd like all of you to come around on the grass area so we can release the butterflies. 1, 2, 3. So let them go. Woo-hoo!
I think today was very powerful. I'm almost overwhelmed.